हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज सोनाली हियर। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द टॉपिक सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट फ्रॉम आर इंग्लिश ग्रामर बुक। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्टिंग लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस यू विद लेट्स रिकैप व्हाट इज अ सेंटेंस। A group of words that makes a complete meaning and gives us a sense is called sentence. Yesterday I have told you about the sentences and about its parts also. Now what is subject and predicate? Subject and predicate are the two parts of a sentence. One is subject and another is predicate. Now, what is subject? Subject is that part of a sentence what tells us that about what or whom we are talking about. Again, I repeat, the part of sentence that tells us about what or whom we are talking is called subject. Now, what is predicate? The part of sentence that tells us what the subject is doing is called predicate. Suppose the subject is a boy and what the boy is doing. So that part which tells us what the boy is doing is called predicate. Now directly we come to the example. Because there is not much to explain about what is subject and predicate, I have already told you about them. We can simply say that the part of sentence that tell us about what and whom is called subject and what, and the part of sentence that tells us what the subject is doing is called predicate. So let's take the example of number one, the children play. About what we are talking here, we are talking about children. What the children are doing, which part is telling us what the children are doing? So simply you can say we are talking about children. So this part is called subject. And what the children are doing? They are playing. So this part is predicate. Okay? So this part is saying what the children are doing. This is telling us the children are playing. So this is predicate. Next sentence is the swans were swimming in the lake. Now same thing can be seen here. Whom for we are talking about? We are talking about the swans. In this sentence, we are talking about swans. So here swans are our subject. And what they are doing? They were swimming in the lake. It is the part of a sentence that telling us about the subject. What the subject is doing? They were swimming in the pool. So the remaining sentence is are predicate. Okay. Now one more kind of question you will be asked in your book also. See the first example. Dash opens at 10 a.m. Anything can be open. You can write here shop. Shop opens at 10 a.m. We can also write here library. Anything can be open at 10 a.m. Any third option you can also think about. Okay. Next example is dash read aloud. So it's a command. So here we need to place subject. So we can write anyone's name here. Let's write. Raman, read aloud. Or you can also write. Shalu, read aloud. Anything we can write. We have to just give them a suitable subject. Next example is, Dash gave me a surprise. Who gave me surprise? Anyone can give surprise. We can write here, my friend. Or we can write, my mom, my dad. Anything what you like, you can write here, my friend gave me a surprise. And this complete our sentence. Next is, Dash sleeps in the cow shed. So who sleeps in the cow shed? Obviously it's cow. Cows sleep in the cow shed. Okay. So this is what I wanted to explain you regarding subject and predicate. What is subject and predicate? Subject and predicate are the parts of a sentence that tell us what and whom is called subject and what the part of sentence, what the subject is doing. That part is predicate. Okay. Hope you have understood. Now, relating exercises are given in the book. Solve them yourself. Okay. Thank you. God bless you. Bye.